हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिस शिवानी देसाई। आई एम वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड इंजीनियरिंग एट के वाघ कॉलेज ऑफ फूड टेक्नोलॉजी नासिक। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी कवर द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट एंड स्टोरेज इंजीनियरिंग विच कवर द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी, देन रोल ऑफ पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी इन एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्शन बूस्टिंग द एग्रीकल्चर इकोनॉमी, देन different components of post-harvest technology. Today, we will discuss the causes of post-harvest losses. So, let us start with the presentation. Then, as we see the production status of India, India is the fastest growing economy in the world and which is the largest producer of several agriculture commodities. India is also the second larger consumer market. We all know the fruits and vegetables are the rising sector of Indian agriculture. India's diverse climate ensures the availability of different varieties of fruits and vegetables in all around the country. India ranks second in total fruits and vegetable production after the China. Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Gujarat, Karnataka are the leading states of fruit production, which have combined share of 51% of total production. Then West Bengal, UP, MP, then Bihar, Gujarat, together accounting 55% of the national vegetable production. But as we see the losses in agriculture production, it is estimated that 5 to 25% losses are occurred in developed countries, whereas 50% in developing countries, which are depending upon the commodities. For example, in case of grains, India accounts 5 to 15% losses, whereas in case of fruits and vegetables, it accounts 30 to 50% losses occurred after the harvesting. Then what is mean by post-harvest losses? It is expressed that a measurable quantitative as well as qualitative losses occurred in fruits, vegetables, grains after the harvesting up to the final consumption by the end user or the consumer. These losses can occur during various stages of post-harvest unit operations. These are the main components of post-harvest technology. For example, harvesting, threshing, cleaning, washing, sorting, then drying, storage, processing, packaging, transportation, distribution, material handling, etc. The losses occurred at every stage of the post-harvest unit operation. These are the different stages at which losses can occur. For example, the 10 to 20% losses occurred due to the lack of pre-cooling, because after the harvesting, the respiration rate is higher in case of fruits and vegetables. So at high temperature and low humidity, the losses occurred, loss of moisture occurred at a higher rate. So 10 to 20% losses occurred during the lack of pre-cooling stage. Then in between the storage, 10 to 15% losses occurred because of lack of infrastructure facilities and improper handling during the storage, then transportation and distribution. You can see it in a picture that right from the harvesting up to the consumption, how losses can occur and what amount of losses occurred due to the lack of pre-cooling, then lack of infrastructure facilities, poor handling and lack of processing facilities, and lack of refrigeration, transportation as well as the storage. So we will see in detail in the next slide. During harvesting, lack of mechanization technologies for the harvesting, then lack of automation in harvesting, then production practices, then moisture losses can occur at high temperature. These losses are occurred during the harvesting stage. Then in food storage unit operation, the insects, deterioration by various factors, then shrinkage due to the moisture loss, spoilage due to the insect, pest or the browning, etc. Then improper handling during the storage can occur the impact damages. Then moisture loss during the storage due to lack of refrigeration storage, then time or the duration we lost between the harvesting and up to the storage can occur, the can contribute to the food losses. Then during the processing, the shrinkage because of moisture loss, then poor handling during the processing, then package failure because packaging should be the gas or the moisture barrier properties. So transportation issues after the processing up to the final consumption, the transportation should be of appropriate condition. So these are contributed to the loss, food losses during the processing. Then packaging, package failure or the transportation issue, lack of packaging or the improper packaging contributed to the losses because packaging should be of having gas or the moisture barrier properties. The moisture loss should not be occurred in because of packaging material. Then during the sale, improper handling, poor inventory or the seasonal items, temperature maintenance contributed to the food losses. Then during consumption, too much leftovers at home level, then in bulk purchase, then poor partitioning can contribute to the food losses during the consumption stage. What are the reasons for the different losses? Lack of clear concept of packing house operation contributed to the losses because pack house operation carried out the packaging, then pre-cooling, then cold storage of the food material up to the final dispatch. So second one is the lack of awareness among the growers, contractors and the policy makers leads to the post-harvest losses. Then lack of infrastructure. The production in India is too much, but as we see the infrastructure facilities, it is inadequate and no good ventilation in the infrastructure facilities. These are not sufficient for the storage of grain, fruits and vegetables during the glut or the excess production season. The next one is a realization of its importance. The education and lack of human resources involved in post-harvest technology, then R&D activities, training, economical viable fruits and vegetable processing units, then lack of extension activities leads to the post-harvest losses. Then inadequate technical support, lack of R&D activities and training, and lack of human resources leads to the post-harvest losses. Then the refrigeration, transportation facilities. To reduce the rate of respiration, the distribution or the transportation should be in a refrigerated vehicles. But lack of the refrigeration vehicles, the losses occurred during the transportation. Then absence of pre-cooling and cold storage because at higher temperature and lower humidity, the respiration rate of fruits and vegetables is higher. So loss of moisture occurred tremendously. So it contributed to the post-harvest losses. Then inadequate market facilities, market intelligence or the market information services contributed to the post-harvest losses because when we use the different intelligent packaging material or the traceability system, it will reduce the losses after the harvesting up to the final consumption. Then unfavorable climate, like as we all know that climate is changing, so mold growth can occur during the rainy season because of lack of storage facilities or the poor storage facilities. Then growth and activity of microorganisms may occur. Then action of enzymes or the chemical reaction causes the losses in food material. Then what are the post-harvest losses? First one is the biological losses. The pests and diseases contributed to the biological losses. You can see it in the pictures. Then chemical, visible external contamination with the pesticide, chemical products, toxic or unpleasant flavor produced by the pathogen contributed to the chemical losses. Then mechanical, different injuries, cut, bruises, grazes, drops, scraping, shatters during the harvesting or the lack of or the poor transportation facilities, impact damage during the handling can contribute to the mechanical losses after the harvesting. Then physical losses like heating, cooling, freezing, because loss of different chemical changes or the physical changes occur during the processing. For example, weight loss, water loss, then texture changes are the included in physical losses. Then physiological losses, sprouting, rooting, senescence, or the changes caused by the transpiration and respiration are included in the physiological losses. For example, greening of potato during the storage. Then loss of moisture can contribute to the wilting or the shrinkage of fruits and vegetables. Then loss of stored energy, for example, carbohydrates. Then loss of other constituents like vitamins. Then physical losses due to the pest and disease attack. These all losses are included in post-harvest losses. So it is most important role of post-harvest technology to reduce the losses. Let us see what are the environmental factors influencing this deterioration. There are four environmental factors plays very important role in deterioration, which influence the deterioration during the storage or the after the harvesting. First one is the temperature. At higher temperature, the respiration rate is higher after the harvesting. So it is most important that after the harvesting, product should be kept in a lower temperature or the cold storage. Then relative humidity. At lower relative humidity, the respiration rate is higher. So higher relative humidity and low temperature are most favorable after the harvesting for the storage of fruits and vegetables. Then atmospheric composition, and fourth one is the ethylene and light. Ethylene, in climacteric fruit, ethylene secretion is continuous after the harvesting. So these four factors should be controlled in a control to reduce the post-harvest losses. Then let us see how we can control or maintain the quality by various activities. The first one is harvesting should be done during the coolest period of the day to maintain the minimal product respiration. So harvesting should be done during the coolest period of the day. So temperature at that time is low. It will reduce the losses of harvested commodity. Then avoid the unnecessary injuries, puncture, wound, crushing, or the damage by human, equipment, or the container. By using appropriate handling harvesting tools, then modern equipment used in process during the processing, then reducing the impact damage by proper handling by human, or refrigeration transportation during the distribution from the processor or the growers up to the final consumption can reduce the losses. Then if possible, we can move the commodity to a refrigerated condition or the post-harvest cooling system as soon as possible. When we kept it for a longer period of time at a higher temperature, the ultimately moisture loss occurred and it will create the post-harvest losses. So as soon as possible, we will move or transfer the commodity to the refrigerated condition for the pre-cooling, and then it will transfer to the cold storage. Then do not compromise with the quality product by mixing damaged, deteriorated, or the decay prone product in a large quantity or the packed unit, because many people insert the damaged or the deteriorated product, we can say it as a adulterant, to fetch the more prices in the market or to increase the quantity of material by adding the decay prone product in a large quantity. But we should not be compromised with the quality, because today in the fast paced world, people are demanding for more qualitative as well as more attractive products. So these activities can reduce the losses and it will maintain the quality of product. So in today's video, we covered what are the post harvest losses, how the losses occur, what are the various reasons behind the post-harvest losses from the harvesting up to the consumption. Then what are the different environmental factors influence the deterioration, and which activities should be done to reduce these losses. Okay, thank you.